Goeiedag manne van graad 11, 2020. Ons gaan kyk na die gedig woorde van Vincent Olifant. Ek gaan gou-gou die gedig lees en dan die gedig vertaal. I'm going to translate it for you as I'm reading it. Okay, my words does not have the power to bring evil powers to a fall. My woorde het nie die krag om bose magte tot 'n val te bring nie. My words can only but sing, bloot sing. My woorde is nie 'n dak om onder te skuil nie. My woorde is te swak. My words is not a roof to hide underneath. My words are too weak. My woorde kan nie keer dat ons die kromme note haal nie. My woorde is kaal. My words cannot stop that we reach the crooked, skewed notes. My words are bare, naked. Believe me, glo tog. My woorde het nie die byt van koels en grof geskit nie. Believe you me. My words doesn't have the bite, the power of bullets and heavy armory. No. My woorde kan bloot bid. My words can but pray and plead in plate and in wens and wish. Medeburgers van die lewe, fellow citizens of the life of life. Dat ons van grense sal vergeet. So he said, my words can only pray and plead and wish, fellow citizens of life, what can it plead? That we forget about our borders, our boundaries, dat ons van grense sal vergeet, en bloot mens sal wees, and just to be human, and to be fellow human. Dit is die vertaling van die gedig. I would suggest that you rewrite this poem in your book, and as you rewrite it, you write the translation down. It definitely help in remembering the meaning of it. Remember, you get the poem in the exam, so that means you only need to know the meaning of each particular word. Okay, so what I will do with this poem, I will quickly just go through it. I only have a few minutes, so I'm not taking too long with it. So don't stitch too much. The questions, obviously, you need to answer, which obviously is also available. Okay. So let's have a look at this poem from that point of view. Have a look at it. The outward structure is obviously what I'm looking at now. So it's the fact that this is three, it's three lines per stanza, it's tercina, you call it the tercina. So all the first three stanzas are strophes, is tercinas. And then the rest of it is 11 lines, which is not, there's not a fixed standard terminology for 11 lines. So it breeds on free verse. Okay, let's continue further. Look at it further. Go through this again. Like I said, 11 rhymes, free verse. And then the rhyme pattern, you can see A, B, B, C, D, C, then it's E, F, G. You can already see it's broken rhyme, gebroken rhyme. It's not a fixed pattern. And then obviously there's a few repetitions there. My woorde, my woorde, my woorde, my woorde. And then that is basically a repetition, okay, at the start of the line. Okay, repetition that is a particular place. That's at the start of the line, of the verse. And then we continue here further. Free verse, no, it's no rhyme pattern. There's no stanza pattern, strophe, not strophe. There's no particular way how things are used. Okay, there's different lengths of the lines, so there's no pattern in it. Okay, it's free verse. Just to move further then, you see that this N here, like I guess it's highlighted N, that you call a particular way of combining sentence. My water can blood, but N plate, N veins, N blood. So that you call pulis and dentum. So it's definitely a way of using conjunctions to add the overuse of voevoer, gebruik van te veel voevoer, not too much. It makes a point in repeating it in such a way to magnify om het groter te maken, to show the power of of the repetition. Okay. Just to go further on it then. Gebed die die kracht van gedig die gedig het die kracht van een gebed. So it's saying in so it makes it powerful in the sense of it adds, accumulates the amount of things that's being asked. Okay. Let's continue further on this poem. We look at Strophe Ian saying that the speaker speaks about his own words has no power, and the only thing that it can do, it cannot do, is he actually shows how it has no power by saying it cannot defeat evil powers, it's negative. And he says it can only sing, so it makes it as if the words are totally powerful because it can only do one thing but sing. And then stanza two says again, he speaks about his own words. He says again how weak his words are, a swak. It's near dak waaronder iemand kan wegkruip. It's not a refuge. He can't take refuge in his words. He feels that anything he says has no real power. Okay, it's very weak. You know, it's when people speak and what they say fall on deaf ears, like we all at times feel. And what's the use of words if it can't achieve anything? This is what the speaker is feeling. I'm not giving any background to it because of the fact that I just want to introduce the poem to you initially because you need to go through it. Like I said, your homework is to write down the poem and translate it. Write down the translation next to it that you can know what it means. Poems have outward forms and inward forms. The inner form is the meaning of it. Okay? Why people are doing certain things. And then obviously against Strophe 3 says, my word, the speaker says, my word, can he cure? It cannot stop. It is machteloos. There's very difficult things that he can't achieve. It cannot hide anything. These words cannot hide anything. So again, going into the detail of the poem, I explained this already, stanza four, Strophe four. He says, it draws a bigger picture of universal worth of humanity. He says, wat sy woorde nie kan doen nie. Okay. It can't stop the bite of bullets and of heavy artillery, grof geskut. What can his words do? His words can only but pray, plead, and wish. You can only that's what the speaker feels his words can do. This poem comes from a time when people felt that they cried and their plight in South Africa fell on deaf ears. It comes from the past when people's words meant nothing to the establishment, to the government. Dit het niks vir die regering bedoel nie. Het gepraat en gepraat en gevra en geskryf en geskree. And the only thing the guy's feeling, that's the only thing his words can do. I think in the current situation in the world, a lot of people feel that their words also mean nothing. That they can feel, they can have attitude, they can say it, but it's not going to change anything. It can't control anything other than give them the feeling of they're saying something. And then it's in lines from line 17 to 20, the spreker spreek die leser aan. He now is talking to everybody. He says, medeburgers van die lewe, fellow citizens of life, everywhere in the world, he says, forget about the boundaries, about the differences, about the fact that we are divided, scaled, forget about it, he says. Forget about your verskille, your differences. He says, just be a person, be a good person, look after each other, give, you know, care for each other, omgee, give, you know, give compassion and understanding to your neighbor. That's what he's saying. In the end, it's like kind of the same thing that we must do in this times that we are living in now, you know. And then at it ends off, you know, saying, what must you know of this, but this poem? Know about three verse, like I said, the building of the strophes, what type of strophe is it? In the poem, he's also using a lot of alleenplaatsing, meaning the words are placed alone in a stanza or placed on its own. And we know that a lot of stuff in poetry is done to beklemtoon, that means to emphasize certain ideas. When you use emphasizes om beklemtoon as an answer, you can't just say om te beklemtoon. You must say, hy gebruik dit om die volgende te beklemtoon. Then you must say, what is he beklemtoon? What is he busy beklemtooning? Okay. Herhaal om te beklemtoon. And everything you can see has to do with the poet wants to emphasize something. This is the word he must use. Okay. Beklemtoon. Continuing on, what's the theme of this poem? I'm busy ending off now. The speaker's words, he says his words can do certain things, very limited. Speakers of words can slechts positive dinge bewerkstellig. You can only do positive stuff. Can't achieve much other than motivating people. The past must not be forgotten. But only the verlede moet vergeet word, al is dit moeilijk te vergeet. He says, move away from the past and move on to a better future. Dit is soos 'n gebed dat alle mense in die wêreld moet vrede saam. It's like a prayer this poem. That all people in the world must use their words positively and must live in peace together. And so the poem basically deals with the fact that words in itself have a limited lifespan and people's actions speaks louder. So jou wyswerk is om die gedig oor te skryf en om hierdie gedig dan te ken om vrae te beantwoord. Jy sal die vrae sal ek later met julle vertaal, maar jy sal die vrae moet beantwoord. I'm not going to give answers to questions, okay? But what you want or must do is then to answer the questions in Afrikaans. A lot of you guys will know this poem after you have explained it to you, but that doesn't mean to say you can answer questions on the poem. Answering questions is the key to anything you do in Afrikaans. And die vraag moet in Afrikaans gedoen word. But now there's ways and means, remember? There's always a way how to say something. But the thing with Afrikaans, find the easiest route. Vind die makkelijkste manier om 'n ding te doen. Because that is in the end what gets you the mark. Not your complicated English terminology. Simplistic answers where you write a clear cut to the point response. Tot volgende keer, manne, alles van die beste, bly veilig, bly gesond, and you know, there's always ways and means how to do something better. Find that way and do it once. Nie 60 keer, manne, een keer, okay? Alles van die beste, ons praat volgende keer weer. Okay, goed gaan.